were very courageous to speak up on social media during the week. Why did you do that for? Why did you go up?
Because I feel like, to be honest, that is one out of millions of messages that I get. But I felt like it's best to draw attention to it now so the people will get drawn out themselves, because I feel like it's not okay for you to just go on social media and feel like you can say whatever you like. So that's why I had to say something.
Troy Deeney has come out today and said that he was attacked as well. He was abused after the heroics in the cup semi-final.
See, I feel like people hide behind football, because I feel like over my career, people, it's okay you hating me for the team that I play for, but people use that to hate you for your colour. And it's sad that more and more each day is coming out, people just being racist over football. So yeah, it's sad to see, but I hope something, we can do something that stops it from happening.
What would you like to see happen? Police action? Twitter accounts taken down?
Something, because I feel like it's too easy to go on social media and say anything and then delete an account, put up another, make up another fake account. So it's like, unless something, I don't know, something that frightens them properly for them to stop doing that, then it won't stop.
Tighter regulations, maybe?
Yeah,
clamp it down.
So, I don't know. I think the clubs, something needs to, I've seen stuff like points deducted from clubs and stuff to make sure they, I don't know, kick out whoever did it, like find out who's doing it, and then you'd never, they're banned from the stadium or whatever, because right now, I feel like it's talked about, but not much is happening.
And credit to Danny Rose and Raheem Sterling for speaking out before you did as well.
Yeah, I was happy to see that, because it's not on. And it's like, we're entertainers. And to be treated like that, I feel like it's unfair.